السلام عليكم جميعا. Okay, شباب, so for quiz 5, which is the last quiz, we'll have it this Thursday. Hopefully it will be done by oscillators. I mean, the majority part of the oscillators by Tuesday. And the quiz will be up to the material of Thursday class. Okay? So what we have covered so far until Tuesday, inshallah. That's this is the last quiz, which is quiz 5. Okay, and of course we'll have our homework and online text, sorry, online test next week. Believe as well as the project, right? صح يا شباب؟
The project, I think it's in 3 December.
December 3rd, which is next week, right?
Yes, next week.
Next week.
So let me continue here. I think the slides are not clear. Do you have it, Shabab, clear in your side?
Yes, doctor.
Yes, doctor, yes.
Okay. Okay, so we talked about the LC oscillators, Colbits and Hartley, and we talked about the difference between these two LC oscillators, which is, what do you think, Shabab? What is the main difference between the Hartley and the Colbits?
Hartley using inductors, well, Colbits using capacitors.
صحيح. Yeah, so if you have two inductors and one capacitor, this is Hartley oscillator. If you have two capacitors and one inductor, that's our Colbits. And as I said, the Shabab, always we are looking for omega, or the current frequency, which is 1/√² of LC, or L equivalency equivalent. Okay, so this is the corner frequency of any of these oscillators. And if this is Hartley, you'll have a series connection, I mean series, yes, connection of L1 and L2. So you have L equivalent to be L1 and L2 plus L2, and the C equivalent to be C1, okay? It's all we'll see in this circuit. For the Colbits, we'll have L1, only one inductor, and then we have two capacitors in series, and then you can find the C equivalent. Okay, let's move to the another interesting type of LC oscillators. It is still LC oscillators, and it is commonly used in most of processors nowadays, even in your watches. So this is what we call crystal oscillators. And we'll not dive deep into the topic, but I'm just giving you some introduction about crystal oscillators, because I think the topic will be complete, or mostly complete, if you cover, or if you are exposed to this type of oscillators. So what is crystal oscillators? So this is very extremely stable. I can both vary as much as I can oscillator, because it will oscillate at very specific frequency. Okay, so if you buy your crystal oscillator to be for example, 5 megahertz of resonance frequency, then your circuit will oscillate exactly at that frequency with a very, very little deviation. And we'll talk about why you are interested in a very stable oscillator in a minute. Okay, so what is this, I mean, crystals, or let's say devices? Actually, these are piezoelectric devices. And what do you know about piezoelectric, Shabab? What do you know about the piezoelectric effect? Let me go, like, a device has a piezoelectric effect. What does that mean? By the way, Shabab, do you have my slides? Okay, because I have another monitor, وطالع عندي مشاكل في المونيتور. I can see, يعني, في lag موجود, في شغلات. Do you see it okay?
Yes.
Okay. Maybe this is an issue from my side for the other monitor. Okay, I will check that. So, what do you know about the piezoelectric effect, Shabab? أحد سمع من قبل عن piezoelectric؟
صراحة ما قد حدث عليه.
إذا في أحد سمع عن المسمى, can you raise your hand? No need to know, I mean, the details, but just the term itself. Okay, only one. Okay, so in general, the piezoelectric devices, these are devices, when you apply some current to them, it will vibrate, tamam? Or it can do the opposite. If you apply some resonance to them, I mean, vibration to them, it will generate electricity. And this is very interesting. بتوقع بعضكم شافها من قبل ممكن. So if you have, let's say we have this strip of piezoelectric and you are moving it up and down, okay? And you are connecting the piezoelectric through a wire to any load. Let's see, we have a load here and you measure the voltage, you'll see it creates electric current and of course it will create some voltage, okay? And you can buy this these devices. It's available all over. And if you heard the term energy harvesting, usually they use these kind of devices to harvest the energy coming from vibrations. Okay, and it can be sensitive devices, or it can. I mean, the sensitivity it depends for these devices. It can be highly sensitive, or it can be like in mid or low sensitivity. Okay, so I think يعني, some of you already see some applications for this piezoelectric, يعني, they're okay, the same term. So the crystals here are actually are piezoelectric devices, okay? So if you apply some current to those devices, the crystals, it will vibrate. Vibrate or resonate, let's say. Let's take the term resonate, okay? So it will resonate at specific frequency. And the frequency will be dependent on the shape of the resonator. طبعاً شباب, we are using specific materials to form these devices. And one of the common crystals, oscillators or devices, what we call quartz wafer or quartz material. So we are using quartz to make these devices. And there are other material you can use, but this is like commonly used and even commercially available everywhere, even in the local market. يعني حتى بالخبر, you can find these devices, okay? And the term, the circuit term, we use this one, I mean the symbol for the circuit, or the circuit symbol of these devices, it's like the capacitor. If you can see it, Shabab, it's like the capacitor, and we add the XTAL, it means crystal, okay? And this is the equivalent impedance or the equivalent resistance, okay? So you have an inductor with a series capacitor. This is the main maybe three parameters, inductor and two capacitors that will change, or it will decide on your frequency of the oscillation, or the omega r, okay, or the frequency of resonance. This r will decide on the quality factor of the crystal, okay? And I think you can find the Z equivalent. If you are interested to find the Z equivalent, you can see the Z equivalent from this side. It is given, by the way, in the book. If you can check the book, you'll find it to be this much. So this is the Z equivalent to be 1 over CSP and then S squared plus 1 over LCS, okay? Over S squared plus CP and then our CS divided by LCSCP. And you can see from here, we have kind of two omega, or let's say two frequencies of interest. We have one over LC, which is omega S. So this is what we call omega S, this one here in the numerator. So this is the equivalent L, of course, under the square root S. And this is what we call the series resonance, okay? And then we have omega P, or the parallel resonance, coming from the denominator here, which is one over, of course, L. What is it? So this is what this one will be L. L C S C P. And let me take this one here. Plus series. Okay, and you can see it, Shabab. If your C S is dominant, you are going for the series resonance, which is omega S. If your CM or CP here, by the way, CP is the same as CM. If it is dominant, then you are going for the parallel resonance. But keep in mind, Shabab, this range between the parallel and the series, it is very, very, very small range, okay? Maybe less than 100 hertz. If you are talking about 5 megahertz of frequency, and then you are talking about quartz or your crystal is changing between 5 megahertz plus or minus 10 hertz or 100 hertz. It doesn't mean anything, right? As if you are resonating at 5 megahertz, exactly. And we'll talk about the deviation. So this band between the omega S and omega B is very, very minimal, okay? And most of the time the CS will take over. Most of the time the CS value will take over this one. For these equations or derivations, it is needed when you want to design the crystal itself. But for you, Shabab, as a designer, what things you are interested in, only to know the resonance value of the quartz, and maybe the voltage, the overall, the voltage you can apply to the quartz or the crystal, okay? So if you want to go and buy any crystal, it is already designed, it is already fabricated to oscillate at 5 megahertz, 1 megahertz, 100 kilohertz, and so on and so forth, okay? So keep this in mind. Okay. طبعاً one thing about the crystal oscillators, they are mechanical oscillators, mechanical resonators, okay? إيش الفائدة شباب أو خلينا نقول what is the downside of mechanical resonators if you want to consider or considering our discussion about the LC oscillators so far? يعني لما أقول لك هذا عندي الآن oscillator عبارة عن mechanical resonator. What is the downside from the the circuit point of view or the performance point of view? Do you see it, Shabab, or not? Do you get the point? معي يا شباب ولا ما انتم معي؟ الآن we have LC oscillators that we discussed so far, right? And those electric or LC oscillators, خلينا نقول op-amp oscillators, the Wien bridge, the phase shifts, and all of that, we can tune the frequency, right? But here in the mechanical oscillators, it cannot be tuned. Yes. I mean, once they are fabricated to oscillate at specific frequency, let's say 5 megahertz, you cannot take this frequency down with the same circuit. You need to apply another circuit, which is what we call frequency division and so on and so forth, okay? So you are stuck with the frequency of selection when you buy these crystals. So keep this in mind, okay?
Okay,
okay, so this is one. Second, another feature of the crystal oscillators, they are very, very stable oscillators. But the question, why we are interested in very stable oscillators? يعني مثلا, If I have a situation of 100 kilohertz, and then my oscillator will oscillate at 100 kilohertz plus minus, for example, 10 kilohertz. يعني خلينا نقول عندنا 90 kilohertz إلى 110 kilohertz. Most of the time, this is okay. يعني even in filters, if you go and apply filters, sometimes you design it to be 10 kilohertz and you'll find it to be 9 kilohertz or 11 or 10.5, and then you need to tune the values somehow. And also, of course, keep in mind you are talking about lab environment. If you are taking that filter out the lab, you'll have a lot of variations to the frequency of oscillation. But why we are interested in very stable oscillators?
For what time and clock.
ممتاز. الكلوك. لاحظ. If you have, I already bring here a situation. If you have a only one point percent deviation, شباب. If you have 0.1% deviation of the time, اللي هو الفريكونسي طبعا, it is the same if you reflect it back to the time, it is the same. Imagine now we want to discuss a difference in the time. The 0.1 deviation will give you, or let me call it the accuracy of the oscillator. The 0.1 deviation or an error will result in almost 1.4 minutes per day, and that will be almost 8 hours a year. يعني تخيل عندك ساعة كل 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 سنة تروح تغير شو اسمها تعدلها من جديد. That's a bad design, right? And that's very bad even for our processors. If you have a processor running at very specific frequency and then you need to calibrate every time, you need to change every time, I mean, that's not a good design. So you need to have a very stable oscillator, okay? طبعاً for crystal oscillators, 0.1 is out of equation. يعني 0.1 deviation, هذا بعيد. يعني most of the time we're talking about maybe something like 0.001% or so. And for that reason, usually they are bringing the idea of using PPM, which is parts per million. And usually we are using this scale, little parts per million, if you have a very small quantity, I mean, or a smaller يعني, value for a large quantity. وعادة نستخدمها بالliquids, so water and so on and so forth. If you want to measure a molecule, وعندك 1 liter of water, then you are talking about PPP, PPM or PPB, اللي هي parts per million or parts per billion. Okay? For example, if I give you مثلا crystal oscillator, accuracy حقه to be مثلا 10 ppm. What does it mean? How much of deviation I have? Almost or the error? من الاسم يا شباب. 10 parts per million. Okay. So this is the deviation of this this crystal or this oscillator. Okay. If I give you to be 10 ppb, that is nothing but 10 over 1 to power 9. Okay. And of course, you can take that one and find your values and so on and so forth. By the way, typical oscillators, maybe they have about microseconds of deviation in 1 year per year for your oscillators. طبعاً, again, it also depends on the design, the circuit design for your oscillators or the system in general. Okay, so let's take now some examples of crystal oscillators. Let's make them into a system or a circuit that we know. By the way, you can replace a shabab the inductor of a Colbert's to using the crystals, because if you go back here and check the value, I mean, we are talking about the value around this value, right? And this between omega S and omega P. And this is an inductive reactance. Although it is given, Shabab, if you are using even in LTSpice, if you are using XTL or the crystals, it will show incapacitance, okay? But the real effect will be inductive somehow. And of course, you can take that from the graph here, or you can think of it as designing a device that resonate at specific frequency. And what we know about this device, it's nothing but as an inductor, okay? So the Colbits, if you go back to the Colbits, so this is the Colbits, right? So this is what we have before. This is a resistor and this is the inductor here, okay? And this is your capacitors. Of course, I am eliminating, sorry. Let me do it this way, okay? This is VDD. And what we can do here, we can go and replace our inductor by a crystal. So we can do this. Okay. And this will change our Colbits. It's still Colbits. We call it Colbits, but using crystal oscillator. So if you see a Shabab, always, if you see this kind of device in your circuit, you are using what? You are using crystal oscillators. This one here. Okay. Any questions so far, Shabab? اليوم الشباب الأحد والجميع متحمس بداية الأسبوع. We need to get some questions. I thought this topic will stimulate يعني somehow some very interesting questions. Any questions? No? Okay, so let's maybe continue for the second one. This is one implementation of the crystal oscillators using what we know so far, which is the Colbits. The other interesting oscillators, and this is usually done and used if you have like logic inverters or if you have CMOS inverters available, okay? So what we do for the peer, this is what we call Pierce oscillators. Again, it comes after the name of the inventor, which his name is Pierce. And then the crystal, this is in general the structure of the circuit. We have an amplifier or an inverter, sorry. This is an inverter, okay? It can be, most of the time, I would say 99.9%. They are using digital inverter, not our op-amp inverter. You know, Shabab, we can do an op-amp inverter, okay? And you can replace this one with an op-amp inverter. But usually, with the Pierce situation, they are using a digital inverter or a CMOS inverter. Let's now first drawing the logic, but then I will draw the circuit. So we have an inverter with a feedback resistor, okay? And then we feed our crystals or our LC tank. By the way, Shabab, you can see this one or you can imagine this one to be what? To be an LC tank, right? So we still have C1, C2, and our crystal oscillators. Okay? C1, C2. I'll come to the Colbits in a second. So this one, because what we know about the inverter, it can be drawn as two parallel, two resistors as such. So this is VDD, this is ground. Let me put it ground here, okay? And now you have your RF here, what's the feedback resistor? And you can have your LC tank to be as such. And if you are interested, you may go and build this one yourself using LTSpice. Okay, then you'll take your V out from here. Of course, you're taking your V out from here. And that will be an oscillator. Of course, you need to meet the condition of oscillation for RF. We're not interested to do that here. We do need to study it. But in general, what we the frequency of here, what will be the frequency of oscillation, Shabab, for the Pierce oscillator here, for this one? مفترض رايت اواي تجي الاجابه بدون تفكير.
ذا فريكونسي اوف ذا كريستال
بالضبط على طول. اوميجا هير ذا فريكونسي اوف اوسيليشن ويل بي ذا اوميجا ريزونانس اوف ذا كريستال. اوكي and that lead me to the second question. What will be the resonance, sorry, what will be the frequency of oscillation of the Colbert using crystal, اللي هو الستركشر الموجود هنا. What do you think of the frequency of oscillation here?
The same as the crystal.
Exactly. احنا كنا من اول نقول ايش, كنا نقول اعطينا ايش يا شباب, الاوميجا of oscillation here will be 1 over L equivalent which is L اللي كانت before and then C1 مع C2 على C1 plus C2, right? But now due to the structure of the crystal and due to the because the omega S, sorry, the omega S or maybe the CS here for the crystal is very very small. And it dominates, by the way, it dominates the value of C1 and C2. So regardless, I can say that, I can claim that, regardless of the value of C1 or maybe يعني for the comparable values of C1 and C2, the omega or the frequency of oscillation here, this is using inductor, okay? And this is using crystal. The omega is, or the frequency of oscillation for the Colbert's using crystal will be exactly omega r, which is the resonance of the crystal itself. تمام؟ مع انك انت رحت هنا واخترت ايش؟ one nanofarad. This one to be maybe the same, that is fine. And then in another case, you change it to 10 nanofarad. This one the same, nanofarad. If you have CS, that is small, CS اللي هو حق الكريستال. smaller than this value, and by the way, the CS of the crystal is very 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 small. It is usually, it comes to be maybe femtofarad, right? So CS is almost 0.001 picofarad around this value. So this is usually true, and if you have this situation, your frequency of oscillation will be the same as the crystal. Okay. If you cannot see it, شباب, maybe I can draw it very quickly. This is the inductor here. This is the capacitor, CS inductor. And then you have your CP, which is of the crystal. And by the way, all of this is replacing the crystal. And we have C1 and C2, right? So this is C1, C2. And I am taking this one to the amplifier from this side and this side. But for now, we are interested in the LC tank itself. Okay? And what is, let me ask you, what is the equivalent capacitance seen by the inductor? لأنه بالأخير إيش القانون حق اللي يعطينا الresonance? It is L equivalent times C equivalent. L عندي ثابتة اللي هي L1. And then I am interested to find the equivalent capacitance seen by the inductor. ايش رايكم يا شباب, what will be the equivalent capacitance seen by the inductor?
C1 series مع C2 parallel مع C2. C1
مع C2 in series, right?
Then parallel مع CP
plus CP in parallel, صح؟ بعدين
series مع كلها مع series مع CS.
كلهم series, لاحظوا انت الان كلهم series مع CS. Which one will be dominant? If you have CS much 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 smaller than this value here, can I cancel this one? I mean, this one will be almost CS, right? And if you do this, in series, sorry, they are in series, right? They are in series. So if this one is, oops, this one should be in parallel, this one in series. So if this is the case, I mean, because CS is very, very small, I can see my C equivalent is nothing but omega or CS. Okay. So I am ignoring, كأني يا شباب, كأني ignoring the effect حق C1 and C2. طبعا C1 and C2 is needed later. لو جاء أحد قال لي خلاص طيب شيل 1 و C2 علشان يصير عندك الأوسيليشن. I cannot do that. لأن عندي condition of insulation طلعنا من قبل. And that's dependent on R and C1 and C2, all of them. Okay? So in this case, your omega or frequency of insulation will be the same as omega S, or in another word, it is the same as your omega resonance of the crystal itself. Okay? The omega S اللي هي حق الكريستال. Yes.
كيف بيطلع CS if CS is very small?
CT okay. is very small, صح؟
ما اسمعك.
كيف بيطلع جواب CS if CS is very small? ما فهمت.
طبعا يا شباب نكشن من هنا البلاس والبارالل هي العلامة خطأ لكن in effect it is in series. طيب, so this طيب, one will be plus. This one will be in series. إيش العلامة اللي أكتبها ما أدري لكن خلونا أكتبها. خلونا أكتب هنا in series. لاحظ فأنت إيش راح تسوي؟ راح تأخذ هذا كامل تضربه في السي اس بعدين تأخذه نفسه تجمع مع السي اس بتأخذ السي اس بيكون الإفكت حقه أعلى.
أي تمام.
زي resistance كان عندك two parallel resistance الأقل منهم هو ال dominant right.
تمام. يقال أيوة. مش مستحيل يكون أعلى من أقل قيمة.
بالضبط هذا هو القاعدة اللي تضبط يعني الجمع والبارالل اللي قبل شوي كان يعني ملخبط شوية. I agree with that. بس إحنا الآن الأقل قيمة بتكون الدومينت. أوكي. So far should be okay. So what else here? Yeah. So this is what we have for the crystal oscillators. Maybe. طبعا I need to delete شباب this one. Okay. Maybe before we close the LC oscillators topic in general, because after this slide we are going for the multivibrators. Let me just introduce you to the idea or the concept of the negative resistance. طبعا بعضكم كان يتساءل من قبل التصور يعني where we can use a negative resistance. Okay. يعني طبعا ما في شيء اسمه تشتري انت نيجاتيف ريزيستنس you can emulate negative resistance you can build a circuit that gives you a negative resistance okay but where we can use it another idea to select or to view the oscillators by using a negative resistance concept I think you still remember that our crystal here sorry mask مع الكريستال our LC tank here and we mentioned that for this LC tank usually if you stimulate the LC tank for any value tamam for any current if you somehow apply some current as if you are exciting the LC tank it will oscillate forever صح يا شباب so it will oscillate forever because this is the nature of the LC tank. It will just resonate at omega equals 1 over LC forever. But in practice, we have some series resistance or maybe parallel resistance. Let's for now include a series resistance here. If you have a series resistance, that's, I mean, it acts like the non-ideality of the LC tank itself. Okay, so let me call it RS. So the negative resistance concept here, someone say, okay, if this is the case, طبعاً, by the way, what is the effect of RS, شباب? إذا قلنا الكباسيتر مع الاندكتر فقط parallel and I excite it somehow, I give it some current and then I leave it. يعني لو كان عندك switch هنا وكان عندك current somehow, you apply that current for small period of time and then you just exclude it the inductor or capacitor will go forever okay or simulate forever but what will be the effect of RS طبعا قبل شوي كنا نقول بدون RS
damped
circuit will oscillate forever كيف
damped oscillation
exactly the oscillation will be not sustained or not be stable. So you'll have some decaying or damping in the oscillation, okay? So after some time, your oscillation will go to zero or converge to zero. That's the effect of RS. نبغاكم يا شباب تهتموا للأفكار, الكونسبت هنا. ما نبغاكم تدخلوا في الكويجنز بدون ننسى المفهوم. So once you have this, how can a shabab I make the circuit oscillate forever in this situation? Considering فقط the elements. يعني مين اللي سبب لي decaying؟ مين اللي سبب لي النزول في الاوسيليشن؟ ال RS صح؟ صح يا شباب؟
يب.
طيب الآن can I go to the ideal case? Can I take this one back to the ideal case where I have a capacitor and inductor somehow? Can I do that and how?
هذا نيجاتيف RS
صح؟ إيش؟
هذا نيجاتيف RS
Exactly. I just add what? If I can add, if there is a way to add a negative resistance, هنا جاء واحد قال أنا بحط negative resistance with the same amount of RS, okay? I can just cancel the effect of RS and then I am back to the ideal case where we have LC and then I have my circuit oscillate, okay? As usual. طيب. How can I implement the negative resistance? طبعا we saw some techniques اللي هو using low amp and other techniques maybe using two op amps. One is using the negative inverter negative impedance inverter or converter. I think we saw also the gyrator. The gyrator can do that. But I will give you another circuit. We'll not analyze it. But in general, this circuit This is the circuit that I want to show. So this circuit here, we have two transistors coupled as such. الدرين يا شباب مشبوك في الجيت حق M1. So drain 2 مشبوك في الجيت حق M1 and vice versa. The drain of M1 is connected to the gate of M2. Okay. And if you have this circuit here, And if I apply a small signal model, you will see that from here, you will see you have a Z equivalent equal to some negative resistance. Okay, let's call it Rx. And then some maybe imaginary part or maybe another reactive element. Okay, so you have some real part, which is negative. وهذا المهم جدا. لأنه عندي real part negative معناته I'm talking about resistance. وعندي إيش reactive part. Reactive part I can play with it later. But this is the more important thing. Okay. So let me call this one X here. Maybe or X. Okay. So I can use the shabab this circuit. And this is what we call cross-coupled transistor to apply our resistor here. And also for completeness. I can just apply LC tank. I can divide the LC tank into parallel LC tank or into خلينا نقول connection to خلينا نقول two sub LC tanks in the system. So what I can do here, I can do this. Okay, this is sorry. Let me capacitor. Oops, inductor. And then my transistor here. This is M1, okay? And then I have the same. Okay, the same thing. لو LC tank آخر. And that one connected to M2. Okay, إيش المسنج هنا يا شباب؟ الجيت 1 والجيت 2 صح؟ فين أشبك الجيت 1؟ الشباب نبغاكم تصحصحوا معنا وين اشبك الجيت 2 اوكي as such so this is VDD and that's ground and this is what this is L and C C and L and this is V out the circuit here this is what we call cross coupled oscillator طبعا من الاسم يا شباب الترانزستور are coupled to each other الدرين مشبوك بالجيت and vice versa طبعا الدرين حق another transistor not the same transistor of course let me ask يا شباب by the way إذا كان الدرين مشبوك في الجيت حق الـ same transistor, what will be the case? What is the transistor or what will be the effect or the model of the transistor? طبعاً هذا استطراد, ها؟ الدرين مشبوك بالجيت. What is this transistor? خلينا نسألكم, هل هو شغال؟ Is it on or off? يلا شباب, is it on or off?
اتوقع انه off. الكونديشن حق الموسفيت المينيمم فولتج اللي يخلي الموسفيت شغال is not satisfied, اللي هي 0.4 كانت او 5.
ليش قلت كذا؟ طبعا we don't know anything about VGS, right? So VGS I can apply to some any kind of biasing, but in this condition, I mean in this structure, what is the condition that we know about the saturation or triode? This is basic, huh? Comes to lecture, I believe, one or two.
This is saturation.
Exactly, saturation. صحيح.
Like the current mirror, if we connect one and leave the other.
Okay. يعني صحيح, لأنه we need another. خلينا كلامك سليم. But for this one, what we call this connection?
Lo ism. Diode connection.
Exactly. This is diode connection. So this is diode connection. Okay. So you can, شباب, imagine this one to be the same as diode. And it is in saturation. And what is the effective resistance seen from here? What is the effective resistance seen from the drain in this case? احنا كنا الeffective resistance seen from the drain إذا كان عندك channel length modulation موجود يصير RO, صح? Or infinity. But in this case, what will be the effective resistance seen from this side? خلونا نعتبر السؤال هذا مراجعة يا شباب.
Infinity or لا?
So in this case, if you have a resistance, طبعا any, and this is applied to any kind of transistor, I mean circuits, and gate. If you are looking from this side here, we are getting infinite resistance, or maybe RO if you want to include the channel length modulation effect. صح? But if you somehow take the gate and connect it to the drain, you are minimizing the resistance to be almost 1 over GM. تمام? You are destroying شباب resistance. يعني تخيل انت كنت infinity صرت 1 over GM, يعني كأنك تطالع من source. صح? احنا لما نطالع من source كنا نقول 1 over GM. والآن من الدرين أيضا عندنا 1 over GM. So keep this in mind. Because if someone say for the cross cable جاء هنا وقال إيش أبشبك الدرين بالجيت, this one will be the circuit will not oscillate mainly, or most of the يعني most likely will not oscillate. Okay. So طبعا I bring you شباب this one here, the cross coupled oscillators, although it's not it's not in the book, but I think it will complete the discussion of the LC oscillators, because at the end of the day I needed to know the main concepts, the main topics, the main circuits that we are using for LC oscillators. And by the way, this is يعني most of on chip oscillators, on chip يعني شباب مش discrete, يعني مش تروح المعمل وتسويها on chip, those are fabricated on chip, they are using this type of oscillators. Okay, طبعا we have something here missing also. If you want شباب to create the same current through M1 and M2, what should I do to the circuit? It comes back to our discussion for the differential amplifiers. إذا بخلي الM1 والM2 كلهم the same current is passing through them عشان يكون عندي kind of balancing here. What do you think I should do? اليوم وضعكم شوية صعب مع بداية الأسبوع شبه. أشوف ما في interaction، ما في discussion. تفضل.
أذكر يا دكتور، we were يعني connecting two sources altogether.
And this is what I'm doing, right? I'm connecting two sources together here, but I am missing something. الآن أتكلم عن currents. I want to force these currents to be equal. Somehow to be equal.
الامبيدنس يا دكتور اللي فوق المفروض تكون equivalent.
Let's take it from the DC point of view. I want these DC currents to be equal. يلا I'm guiding
connect
you to the answer. إيش؟
Connect the gate.
إيش؟
The gates of the two transistors.
لا الجيت احنا نبغى الجيت مشبوك في الدرين والثاني الجيت مشبوك في الدرين. لو صارت شبكة الجيت بال any other sources بيكون مشكلة. يعني الجيت لو شبكتهم بالجيت مع بعض راحت عندي المشكلة. رجعنا للكيس حق الدايود اللي كنت أتكلم عنه، وهذه you are destroying the circuit. عندك two currents I1 أو I2 و I1 هنا DC currents تبغاهم exactly the same and you have a symmetry here and I want to force those currents to be the same.
نقدر نسوي mirroring يا دكتور.
What do you think of current source؟ صح؟ yes. احنا كنا نعمل differential amplifier، ما نحط differential amplifier اللي نحط مع current source اللي هو tail current نسميه، right؟ So you can see it يا شباب، it is very close to the differential amplifier. يعني ممكن نجيب لك السيركت زي كذا and it looks like a differential amplifier but at this, but the end of the day it is an oscillator actually. You don't have an input voltage. الجيت هنا لو تلاحظ الجيتس هذولي they are not connected to the input voltage. They are connected to the drain now. يعني if you شباب disconnect this one here and this one here, now you have the differential amplifier structure regardless of the LC tank that you have here. Okay? But you can turn the differential amplifier to into an insulator as such. طبعا أنا بدأت متأخر ومعلش أخذت منكم دقيقتين لكن بدأت متأخر. Okay? I think this one close our discussion for the LC oscillators. We'll talk about multivibrators إن شاء الله next class. If you don't have questions, see you inshallah next class. تكم العافية شباب. شباب اللي عندي بس I'm trying to close the recording. تفضل حسن.
بس عندي استفسار على